Shamrocks win. Shamrocks win again.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another exciting year of St. Patrick basketball for this 2014-2015 season. We welcome you back to Curling Court. It's good to be back here. I'm Paul Meisner, class of 2015, joined by a couple of new recruits.
Hi, I'm Matt Shimrowski, class of 2015.
And I'm Anthony Pasquale, class of 2018.
It's a pleasure to have you boys here. Always good to have some fresh new recruits after Donnie Rollins went off to Benedictine. Congratulations to him.
Oh, congratulations. I'm glad to be here, Paul. It's going to be a great night of basketball.
It definitely should be. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a very fast and victorious start for the St. Patrick High School Shamrocks. They won our Thanksgiving tournament, pretty much dominating everybody. They defeated Phillips and Julian and were able to knock off a number 24-ranked Hyde Park, which was a big win.
It was a good game. Good game.
It was. And then they went off to the next leg to play in the finals, where they defeated Hershey 59-39. And that's where we stand as of right now, with St. Patrick currently leading the ESCC, one of the best overall conferences in the entire state of Illinois, at 4-0. Behind them are Marion Central Catholic, St. Vider, Marist, and Notre Dame, all undefeated right now, just to show you how tough of a conference this is.
Yeah, we got some good teams this year. It's going to be some great basketball.
It definitely should be. Tonight we play Immaculate Conception from Elmhurst, Illinois. They've also done a very good job as well, knocking off a lot of good teams in their tournaments. They defeated Serena 88-36, a real blowout there. They defeated Morris by 20, 73-53. They defeated Cole City 52-30, and defeated Gardner South Wilmington 48-24. So they've really been on fire so far.
As we approach the tip-off, I'm looking for this game to be fast-paced.
Fair enough. And our new recruit, our freshman, Anthony Pasquale. Pleasure to have him on.
Pleasure, man.
So he's going to introduce his new segment, the three keys to the game, just after the national anthem. So we will leave you with that.
Before we begin the next contest, I'd ask that you please all rise and remove your hats and join the St. Patrick High School Cup Band in the singing and playing of our national anthem. Thank you.
We're now going to go to Mr. Pasquale's three keys to the game.
I like to call on my life insurance here tonight. I spoke to Coach Bailey earlier, and he told me that the three keys to the game are, number one, our transition defense has to be set. Number two, we have to have good shot selection. And the third key to the game is we need to limit our turnovers tonight. I was talking to Coach Bailey, and I wished him luck, and he told me he did not need luck. He needed rebounds.
All right, thank you. Good to have Anthony Pasquale here as the Immaculate Conception guys start to come out. A very good team, actually. Very dominant in the 2A category. Hopefully, though, we face tougher talents since our St. Patrick Shamrocks are in the 3A, so hopefully we can get a win over them tonight.
Yeah, it's a very good team. Actually, last year, St. Pat's lost to this team by 30 points. So they're calling this game the revenge game, which I like because revenge is always nice. And pay attention here as they introduce the Shamrock starting five.
Lineup.
Here we go. We got Nikki Splash, Nick Coleman coming out here, four-year varsity player. Great kid.
Definitely the best guy on the team.
Yeah. And now we got a junior here, Sean Eck, who's he's been playing pretty well for the Shamrocks at the two-card spot.
He has been. He definitely has been so far.
This is my guy, Perchanowski, the small forward. Shoots threes like it's his job. Great player.
Perch. Great memories from last year.
Great player.
Indeed.
Now here's a guy, Andy, who came here last year. He transferred here. He's only been here his second year at Pats, but he's been a real great addition to this basketball team.
He definitely has.
And last but not least, our student council vice president, Duncan White.
The one and only.
Biggest guy on our team. He's our big guy, I guess.
He is the tallest. That's really going to be an issue again this year for St. Pat's. It was an issue last year. It's going to be an issue again this year. Is that although we can play very well offensively, and the team has a great togetherness since it's been around each other so much, it's not very tall, which admittedly is going to cost it some stuff, I believe.
Yeah, no, we're playing a team with a couple 6'5", 6'6", guys, you know. So we got some size against us today, and we're going to see the challenge of our big men against these really big men. I mean, it's going to be a good one.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be one of the crucial points.
I think it's important for our Shamrocks to move fast against these big men so they can take advantage.
Definitely. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're just about ready for our first tip-off game of the season. We want to welcome you all. Thanks for coming back. You can email us at sphswebcast@stpatrick.org, all lowercase, or tweet us at sphswebcast, all lowercase, no spacing. As we get ready for the tip-off here, and Andy Velasquez is not going to be able to get it. And Immaculate Conception will take it out here as Troy Burrows has the ball. Burrows looking for something. Passes back over to Burrows.
Now we're seeing a little 2-3 here, which I kind of like. Against these big guys, we're going to have to get this ball moved around here and try to get a stop on defense.
Definitely. Out to the three. No good. But they get their rebound. And no good.
IC starts with a couple of bricks here. I kind of like it.
Yeah, definitely. Nick Coleman takes it out over to Sean Eck. Sean Eck over to Andy Velasquez. Andy Velasquez can hold the top of the key back over to Nick Coleman. Coleman looking for something. Gets it to Sean Eck. Sean Eck's going to bring it around. Sean Eck over to Adrian Perchanowski, but it's stolen. They're going to try to take it up. They're going to pass it back out. Going to pass it over to, I believe, Troy Burrows. Takes the three. No good.
The Shamrocks in their 2-3 zone. I think that it's important to protect the paint against IC's big men.
Definitely. Andy Velasquez goes up, and he got fouled. They'll go to the line.
For two.
Two.
Oh, never mind. That was called an offensive foul.
Oh, that's kind of surprising.
Wow. I can't say I agree with that one, folks. That was, ooh. Oh, my.
It's Troy Burrows going to bring it out now. Burrows. Over to JT Bond, back over to Burrows. Burrows looking for something. Back over to Bond. Back to Burrows. Oh, my bad, that is Rashawn Epting. He's been lethal in his past couple of games, scoring 45 points in his first game, and then hitting, nice block! Xavier Perchanowski gonna bring it up, and that'll be a foul.
A
Good job there by Kirsch.
I didn't know that was football. He just got a tackle into the ground there. I'm not a big fan of that one.
John Simmons, I believe. But yes, Rashawn Epting has been lethal so far in three games. He scored 45 and one and hit 6 three-pointers in both. He's averaging 30 points a game, so we're definitely going to have to keep him in check. Sean Eck looking for something now. Sean Eck still looking, passes over to Perchanowski. Perchanowski, top of waiting around the three-pointer. Duncan White back over to Sean Eck. Sean Eck to Nick Coleman with the wide open three. No good.
Nicky Splash going to get it that time, but hey, he never starts off that strong, but he always finishes at the end here.
Rashawn Epting looking for something.
So far, I like our Shamrocks' approach on offense. They're waiting to find a good shot.
He's going to go up, and I see he'll get the first points of this game. Unfortunately, the big man gets to the rim, and that'll cost him, as Sean Eck brings the ball out now.
The first points did not come until 3 minutes into this game. Might be a low-scoring one.
As Adrian Perchanowski goes up. Oh.
That would be icy ball.
He was close there. He was close. As Icy's going to take it out now to Troy Burrows. Troy Burrows over to Sean Epting. Burrows over to Austin Reed. Back over to Finn. To Reed. Back over to Burrows. Burrows at the top of the key trying to find something. Passes back in. Right up to the rim. No good, but look at the rebounds.
That was some good defense by Andy there. We just got to grab the rebound.
Definitely, definitely. Perchanowski over to Epting. They're just passing it back and forth outside at the top of the key. Epting trying to find something. And that'll be blocked, and Shamrock ball.
IC gets a lot of second chance points because they're very good on the offensive glass because they're big.
Definitely. As Marcus Mercado is going to get subbed in. He broke his nose, so if you see his mask, if you're wondering out of curiosity, that is why he has a mask on.
We like to call him Zorro around here. Bit of a nickname. Isaac Moore also checked in.
Good to see him.
President of our student council.
As Adrian Perchanowski looking for something. Thought about taking the shot there. Didn't with the floater. No good. And Perchanowski gets a little rebound, though. Oh, and he got blocked there.
I think Marcus might be a little nervous because he hasn't put his mask all the way on yet. It's just resting on the top of his forehead.
He should probably get that on. I don't want to see him re-break his nose. That would be bad for this team around.
It'd be bad.
And no, he's...
He's keeping it off, I guess, is the new strategy.
I mean, I got to imagine it's kind of hard to see out of the thing, so that's a fair point.
Yeah.
As the ball's going to come to him now. Marcus Mercado over... I believe a foul on Immaculate Conception. Yes, a foul on Austin Reed, his first, and the second for the team. With 4:29 left here in the first, 2-0 Immaculate Conception over St. Patrick. As Nick Coleman looking around, passes it to Marcus Mercado. Mercado tries to lead it in, and I believe a foul on Immaculate Conception.
And now he just took it off again, okay. As you can see, the man sitting down and, by the black wall there, that's a cameraman, Patrick Gorski. He's taking pictures right now of the game.
Yeah, he works for Max Prep. He has some really good shots. I've seen him. So I believe you can find him at Max Prep's under Patrick Gorski. I believe he has his own page, so if you are interested in purchasing any of his photos, he's
got a
cameraman.
Couple great shots of me.
Former cameraman of ours here, moving on up. So you can see him right there. That foul is, I believe, on Austin Reed again. As Nick Coleman now looking for something. Passes it over to Perchanowski. Perchanowski with the three. No good.
Ooh.
Oh, nearly went back in. Isaac Moore with the rebound.
Isaac,
got it.
Give me more.
A nice rebound there by Isaac Moore on the putback.
Gotta love me some Isaac.
As they're driving, no good on the shot there. Marcus Mercado get the rebound. Good job there.
I don't think Duncan White likes the jump. He just kind of puts his arms up and hopes for the best. But hey, it worked. Got a block on that one.
Oh, Perchanowski with the three.
That's what they call the Polish sniper right there, boys.
Perch It is 5-2 with 3:35 left. And Isaac gonna take the three, no good. Look at the rebound though. And a foul. Who's that gonna be on? As they're about to inbound the ball now. Oh, what was that?
Good sportsmanship there. The enemy helping up a fellow friend, Nick Coleman.
As a couple of the Immaculate Conception guys are going to come out. As Isaac Moore getting ready to inbound the ball here, and he will inbound. As Nick Coleman's going to bring it up now.
Definitely.
He's been on the varsity team ever since he came to this school. Shows you how good he is. Stuck in white now over to Adrian Perchinowski. Perchinowski to Isaac Moore. Isaac Moore looking for something. Over to Perchinowski. Perchinowski.
Ooh, a nice crossover there.
Right, oh. He was close there. He had a nice look. Gotta make those shots count. With 2:40 left here in the first, 5-2, currently Shamrocks. It's been a defensive battle, and I don't know if that's an offensive charging call or...
I think he tried to hurdle Duncan White there, I'm not really sure.
Yeah, he's going to the line for two though. I believe at least it will appear so, yes he is. Rashawn Efton going to the line for two.
Pierce, he hurt his left hand on that fall there. Might impact these free throws.
And he will make the first, making it 5-3 with 2:35 left here.
Guchman is a junior here. He's 6'4", so he's tied for the tallest guy on our team, along with Duncan White.
As Isaac Moore inbounds it to Nick Coleman. It's 5-4 now. Still St. Patrick lead. It's Coleman looking over to Perchinowski. Perchinowski looking for something. Over to Marcus Mercado. Mercado to Moore. Moore over to Mercado. Mercado to Perchinowski. Perchinowski, oh, ball stolen. And I believe a foul at Magnum second.
Looks like he got a shoulder to the face on that one.
He does show a lot of commitment. As Isaac Moore's getting inbound the ball here. Six fouls already for Immaculate Conception. They're looking like they're in trouble. So Sean Eck. Sean Eck bringing the ball up over to Isaac Moore. Isaac looking for something. Isaac to Nick Coleman. Nick Coleman with the floater, no good, and we won't be able to get the rebound. As Rashawn Efton's gonna bring it up now. Rashawn Efton. Over to Troy Burrows, and a foul call. A lot of fouls already, 9 fouls so far, and the 10th coming.
Yeah, I really feel like this is gonna be a defensive game here. It doesn't look like it's gonna be a lot of high scoring, but just wait till Nikki Splash gets going here.
It's 5-4 with a minute 44 to go, still Shamrock lead. Already 10 fouls called. That's never a good sign. And, oh, nice play there by Jordan Rowell.
Isaac got lucky there. It looked like there was a little extra contact after that shot.
Yeah. As it'll be 6-5 now with a minute 25 left in back of the conception over St. Pat's. Isaac Moore trying to find something over to the key. Back over to Sean Eck. Sean Eck. And they get the shot. That was a three-pointer there.
By Isaac Moore, baby. Give me some more of that.
As Burrows now. Over Burrows. No good. Over to Nick Coleman. As Andy Velasquez now up. And he got another foul.
Han died and won.
As that'll make it 10-6 with 51 seconds to go. And Andy's going to the line to try to make it a three-point play. As he goes, get ready for the shot. And he got it. And he's going to inbound the ball now. To Stone Brinkman, who passes back over to Troy Burrows. Burrows to Angel Ramirez. Angel Ramirez back over to Burrows. Burrows to Efting. He airmailed that one. And now Isaac Moore brings it up. Oh, and he's going to miss it.
Yeah, Efting kind of looked like me there with that air ball three.
That was not a good shot there, unfortunately. He had a decent look, though.
Yeah, good shot selection, but just couldn't get it to go. I think it was just straight all air ball. I didn't really see a hand on that one.
Yeah. With 20 seconds left here, 11-6. Pats over IC. They're trying to pass around now. Okay. Oh, a nice tip there by Eddie Velasquez, but it goes right back to Adrian Ramirez, and he'll get the layup. Oh, the ball stolen. And that'll be the end of the first. And a sudden surge there by IC, and they will be able to pull it within one here, 11-10 at the end of the first.
Yeah, they're definitely going to carry that momentum they had at the end there into the second quarter.
Definitely. So a very defensive first half.
Yeah, very, very good defensively besides all the fouls. But.
Yes, as of right now, we have 11 fouls, and the highest team has 11 points. So it's going to be a very defensive game, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hope so. He's always so lethal with the three-pointer, which really helps us out. Hopefully we can keep, we can get him going. So ladies and gentlemen, I hope everybody's doing well out there. It's good to be back.
Yeah, it's good to be back. Good to be here.
Yes, it's very exciting to have our two new broadcasters here. It's going to be some good stuff this year, hopefully, with the team doing so well already, off to a 4-0 start. I believe our next game, ladies and gentlemen, that you should really come out to is, let me check the dates here just to be sure, it is December 19th, the biggest game of the year here at Curlin Court. Our friendly neighbors in Niles, Notre Dame, come up down south here to play. That'll be probably the biggest game of the year.
It's on my calendar, I'll tell you that, Paul.
We're going to pass it along here to our freshman, Anthony Pasquale, as we will be, since we're two seniors, enjoying our final Notre Dame game here. Always fond memories.
Oh, yeah, great memories in that stud section.
Definitely. Some of the best moments of my time here have come from games. I remember I was broadcasting your sophomore year for a game against ND, and it is the fullest I've ever seen.
Ooh,
this place.
That game was that was a doozy, let me tell you that.
That was the most intense game I think I've ever been a part of, as we get back to the game now here. Nicky Coleman misses the three there. And there's a possibility that happened to me, and that'll be a traveling violation against the Shamrocks, I believe.
Now, they say he was traveling, but I didn't see his suitcase, so I don't know how he could go anywhere.
It is an interesting question. It's a good question, Sam. Coach Madsen. As IC is going to take it out now by Troy Burrows.
Just under 8 minutes left in this quarter.
As takes the three, no good, but he'll get his own rebound there. And he'll take the shot, and he got it. And that'll give the IC the lead at 12-11 with 7:20 left here. So they're going to pass it up to Perjanowski now.
The big part in this game is the Shamrocks can start.
Yeah, they've definitely missed a lot of rebounds on their own side and a lot of rebounds that against IC here. As Isaac goes for the layup, he can't get it. Goes back for it, and he'll be called.
Yeah, he's struggling right now, but he's fighting hard. He's working at it. He's gonna get into it. Don't worry, folks.
7 minutes left here, 12-11. As Troy Burrows, as they're just trying to keep away right now, outside of the arc, as they're gonna pass it into the paint. And that's a traveling violation on IC.
You ain't Kobe, you can't shoot that.
As Nick Coleman can inbound the ball. Sean X gonna take it out. They definitely have. Adrian Perchinowski going in line here. 8 fouls already for the Immaculate Conception Knights. That's a lot already for considering the fact we've only played 10 minutes of game time.
Yeah, that's troubling out there.
That's troubling for them. Hopefully good for us, though.
Yeah. We got to really utilize these shots at the line right now. Got to get them to go.
Adrian Perchinowski get the first to tie this game. 12-12 with 6:34 left here.
Been a real bright spot for our team this year.
He definitely has. As Perchinowski. Perchinowski can dunk this year, I've heard reports. Hopefully we can actually see that sometime during the game.
That's what we've heard, but I haven't seen anything, so he's got to prove it to me.
He's keeping it in secret, waiting for us, as we make the second free throw, and it's 13-12 now with 6:30 left here. As Angel Ramirez is trying to pass back and forth, play keep away. Ramirez over to Jordan Rao. Back out to the three-point line, and he's going to miss it. They'll get the rebound.
He just kind of threw it off Isaac's arm there, and that's how IC can keep the ball.
Yeah, that's a shame there.
Looks like Dewey checked into the game here.
I believe his first minutes of the season, if I'm not mistaken. Good to see Dewey out there. Howard Angel Ramirez. And he got straight blocked there. Fantastic play.
I see looking to inbound the ball. They get it in.
Oh, they got three people on him there. And it'll be our ball. Fantastic defense there. Big key to the game.
Right now we got an email from senior here at St. Pat's, Michael Sullivan. Love tuning in to watch the SPH webcast on Ustream to listen to Paul Meisner and the Stacey King the Bee. I think he's referring to me. Love some of Shemorowski's sayings. I don't know. He's just trying to kiss up to me, I guess. But, thanks, Mike Sol, for watching, and we'll keep you reminding you about our viewers' emails and telling you a bit of how they liked us so far.
We hope you like us. We hope there's no negative feedback. We didn't have any last year. We're trying to keep it that way, as that'll be a foul against Immaculate Conception here. With 5:19 left, 15-12 currently, Shamrocks. As the stud section out in force tonight, as we have a lot of eighth graders coming in tonight with our Rock the House night. As a timeout called, I believe. Always good to see the stud section up. They will definitely be out in full force next week for Notre Dame.
Oh, it's going to be packed here. If you're planning on coming to the ND game, get here early. It's going to be hard to find a spot.
And since you're on the student council, would you care to tell us the great theme that you guys thought of?
The great theme we've thought of for the ND game in a couple weeks is WWE theme. For those of you not familiar, it's Worldwide Wrestling Entertainment. It's going to be a great theme. I plan on dressing as Mr. Kennedy. Maybe you'll see me out there in the stud section. It's going to be a great day for the Shamrocks.
I don't know what I'm going to be dressing up as, but I'm going to guarantee I'm going to have a great time.
You're definitely going to dress up as Batista. That's what you kind of look like, Paul.
You know that he actually got cast to do the new James Bond movie with Christopher Waltz. He's going to be a villain.
Wow, that's...
I am hoping our
definitely, as our young Anthony Pasquale here is going to be taking over the reins. We will be out in the stud section, as stated before, because this is our final in D game, and we really want to live it up. So join us, I believe, two Fridays from now, if I'm not mistaken.
Two Fridays from now, that is correct, Paul.
At the end of our finals, so all the students will be joyous, have nothing to do. That's a shame there.
Hey, maybe that's all Nick needs to get going here is a little easy shot there.
That's actually a shame because it's a foul against IC, and he made the three, which, of course, is nitty, doesn't count.
And Nick Coleman is the guy who he's been playing varsity all 4 years. He all-conference player last year, junior year. Went far in the three-point contest, so I'm pretty sure he's gonna get it going eventually.
He's a very good leader.
He is the leader. He is El Capitan. As Dewey's going to make the first shot here with 5:06 to go, 16-12.
It's big that we're already having the bonus. We still have 5 minutes of play here in the first half.
It definitely is, as that'll make it 17-12 as he makes a second free throw. With 5 minutes to go here, as Icy's going to take the ball out by Troy Burrows now. As, what's going on here? Sorry, folks, working out the kinks. Angel Ramirez, I believe that is. Over to Dora Roswell. Epting, I believe Epting got fouled.
Yeah, I don't like that call. Looks like he just kind of dropped the ball.
Yeah, I didn't really think there was much there. But we're not the refs. We merely say what happens during the game. That would be pretty nice if we could dictate from up here what was happening on the court.
Mm-hmm.
As it'll be an inbounder now. Fifth foul for the Shamrocks. Currently at 9 for IC. We're down the bonus. As nice stolen ball there by Dewey. Up to Isaac Moore. Isaac fell over there.
Looks like Isaac slipped on the floor there. Looks all right, though. That's good.
That's not good there, as it'll still be our ball, though. That's good. That was an odd play. Hopefully he's okay and his leg isn't hurt.
Seems to be moving just fine.
That's good. Perch inbounds it to Andy Velasquez, but it'll be IC ball. As that'll be against Sean Eck, his first six for the team. So 14 fouls already, folks, and it's only 17-12. With 4:35 left here, as IC is going to inbound the ball. And they're going to get into the paint, and they'll get the shot there, 17-14. As we said, the real key is to make sure, since they have such tall guys, that they are not going to be able to access the paint. Isaac Moore with the three, no good.
Big offensive.
It'll stay for the Shamrocks, though. And a nice play there.
I think Patrick Gorski just touched his first basketball, helping out the referee there.
Thank you there, Mr. Gorski.
Just hang on to the camera, bud.
Big moment for Pat.
It's a great day for him. Great day. You got to touch the football. You got to touch the basketball. Sean Eck into Andy Velasquez. Andy triple teamed. Out for the three.
Ooh.
Oh, Perch. Perch here. Or Dewey. That was Dewey. My bad. Dewey kind of airmailed that one.
So now Perch. A lot of offensive rebounds.
And the foul there. Nice job there by Perch.
Perch and Isaac were fighting hard down there. You got to like it.
Yeah, definitely outnumbered there. About 4-2. 4 minutes to go here in the second. 17-14.
Free throws are going to be vital tonight. And so far the Shamrocks have converted on most of them. Another free throw, good.
So look at that one. When they give you free points, you got to take them.
Yeah, it's free cheese, man. The Rats got to take them.
Definitely. 18-14 now.
I think the ref was commenting on his shoes there.
He does have some pretty nice green shoes, if I remember searching correctly. As Perch now going to go, trying to make a 2-2. And he'll do it.
He'll do it. He's been on fire from the line tonight. Well, he should be. They are free points.
19-14 now with 3:55 left here.
Shamrocks with a nice lead. Hopefully they can build on it.
Hopefully. Because a lot of our games so far have been close in the first half, but the Shamrocks have really been able to pull away in the third quarter. So hopefully they're more of the same tonight.
Yeah, I think they like to tease the other team, think they have a chance, but they always seem to pull away, which is a good attribute to have.
Cat and mice playing with the rat and the cheese.
That was a bad shot there. Wide open look, but airballed it. And a foul call on somebody.
As I said, one of the earlier keys was good transition defense. The IC hasn't been able to generate a lot of fast break points. They've had to settle down with their offense, and it hasn't bid them well so far.
Yes, definitely, definitely. As Troy Burrows goes to the line for two now.
Shamrocks aren't really giving them a lot of room to work here, which is good.
Protecting the paint, just like I like it.
You always see their arms up on defense, as Coach Bailey probably just nailed that into their head.
He likes to say, pub up, keep up your palms.
As 19-15 now, 17 fouls so far in this game. It's going to be one of those games, folks.
I don't even foul that much in 2K, folks. That's wow.
Shamrock's lead cut to three. Hopefully they can build on it this offensive possession. Sean Eck with the ball here.
Sean Eck now looking for something. Defense pretty tight here over to Andy Velasquez. Andy trying to find something here. They got all the boys covered right now. Andy going to drive to the lane. Got it.
They just gave him that one. Once he got that crossover, he just had an easy land.
Great single effort there.
5-point lead for our Rocks.
With 2:55 left, 21-16. As Troy Burrows over. Double team now. Now triple team. Back out to Angel Ramirez. Angel looking for something.
This is suffocating defense, Paul. You got to really respect that.
Oh, Dewey stole the ball. And Isaac will get it back. Off to Dewey. No, oh, now it's taken back. As I think they tried to grab onto Isaac Moore's legs there. The three. Ooh. Got it.
Coach Bailey's 2-3 zone is almost as lethal as Syracuse's. Maybe he took some notes from Jim Boeheim.
That'd be good. Syracuse is one of the top teams in the nation. As I'm not sure if it's a timeout or a foul here.
We cut to two for our Shamrocks.
I believe that's the first three they've made tonight. A lot of them have been air balls so far. We've been lucky with that.
Hopefully that three doesn't spark anything in the future.
Hopefully as Dewey goes to the line for two. I'm not quite sure for what. But I don't care.
If we're getting shots, I'll take them. They're free.
Exactly. As Dewey going to the line for what I assume is two.
Now we're in the double bonus, so each time you go to the line, it's two, not just one and one anymore.
As Dewey's going to miss the first, that's not good.
He'll get the second one in, I'm sure.
You could build a couple houses with the bricks we've had tonight, folks. It's a couple missed shots here and there, you know.
Definitely, definitely. Mostly by IC, which we've been lucky for.
Yeah.
As Dewey will get that one, pushing the lead back up to three with 2:24 left here.
Sham, have you ever considered going stand-up?
I don't think my knees can handle it.
Manchester Rowski, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, my mom thinks I'm funny, so.
That's all that matters in life. As Troy Burrows over to Angel Ramirez. Angel Ramirez back over to Troy Burrows. Troy Burrows trying to get into the lane and foul, I believe, against the Shamrocks.
Coach Bailey does not like that call, and I'm not a huge fan of it either.
Yeah, Coach Bailey always seems to get mad at a couple calls here and there. I think it was sophomore year, I remember one game, playoff game against Maine South, I believe. I remember he threw his glasses on the ground. I don't think his wife would like him breaking his glasses like that, but hey.
Great hustle by Isaac Moore diving on the ball.
Definitely.
I love to see that play from our Shamrocks.
The foul count now up to 18.
Here comes Marcus Mercota. He's about to check in.
It's Zorro time.
Shamrocks back to the line. This time Isaac Moore's taking his first two free throws tonight.
With a minute 58 left here, 22-19 currently, Shamrocks over IC. As Isaac Moore gets ready for the shot.
Got our magic fingers from the stud section.
So it won't work that time as he misses the first one.
It appears there is someone on the scoreboard cam trying to steal the show with his face in there. Don't know what he's doing, but
we see you. Mr. Doyle not happy in the broadcast booth there. He's going after him.
That guy better watch out. Isaac will get the second one to go.
As that'll push it up to a 5-point lead then. No, four. Four, my apologies. 23-19 here with a minute and 50 seconds to go. As I see passing it around the key now. Looking for something.
Marcus checked in for Dewey a couple of minutes ago.
Dewey's been playing well, actually. This is the first, I believe, some of the first minutes he's had. or at least significant time, as he completely airballs that pass right into the stud section. That's what we like to see.
Yeah, from what I hear, I believe Dewey wasn't so sure if he wanted to even play this year. Coach has probably talked him into it. A couple leaders on the team talked him into it, and I'm happy we have him. He's playing well today.
So a lot of Shamrocks coming in out to the stud section. That's good to see. Sean Eck now. Looking for something. Sean Eck going to bring it to the three-point line. Passes over to, I believe, Marcus Mercado.
Our offense has been very patient, trying to capitalize on one of our keys to
Coleman
the game.
And the...
It's good.
Getting your guards mixed up there, Paul. I believe that was Sean Eck right there.
My apologies. Nice play there by Sean Eck.
White Thunder.
As we like to call him, he makes some big plays, and they're as loud as thunder. So,
big spark for our team. Could call him Sparky if we wanted.
And Sean Eck. We'll make the three-point play.
Lead is now 7 for our Shamrocks.
With a minute 18 left to go here, 26-19. As IC is going to bring it up now. Over to Troy Burrows. Burrows looking for something. Over, trying to pass it around the key here. Can't find much. Over, still looking. Still looking. Passes it back. To Andrew Ramirez. Over to, I believe, Troy Burrows. Burrows looking for something here as we're under a minute with about 50 seconds to go here. As Hyde Park had an interesting concept of holding the ball for about 2.5 minutes.
Oh, that was brutal. It was a bit of a boring game once they try to hold that ball for a while. I think they're trying to use the same strategy here.
As the stud section chanting boring in their disapproval, as they're just going to pass the ball around here as we get ready for 30 seconds. They're going to drive to the lane. Intramuros with a shot, and he airballed that one. A lot of air balls so far.
Sean Eck's bringing up with about 30 seconds left in this one. Maybe they could get something going.
And Zach, over to, I believe that's Marcus Mercado.
If they hit a three here, they can push the lead to 10.
Andy Velasquez over to Mercado. Mercado to Sean Eck. As we get here to 10 seconds, they're just going to hold probably for the last shot. Eck going to drive the lane, passes it out. Open
for
three. Got him!
The lead is 10.
The Polish Prince.
And he's not going to make that. And we head into halftime at 29-19. A great last couple minutes there for our Shamrocks to push the lead to 10.
The lead is 10, and I'm feeling happy about it.
Definitely a great first half there. Who would you say was the MVP of the first half so far?
I have to give it to Andy and Duncan White with their defense inside the paint. It's really slowing down the IC's offense, and you got to really love that kind of play.
Definitely, definitely.
Offensively, I think Perch has had a great game, especially on the line.
Definitely, definitely. All right, ladies and gentlemen. I believe now we are going to be cutting to an interview that me and Matt Chemrowski here did with Coach Bailey a couple weeks ago now, as he talked about the start of the season, how he felt about the team, how he felt about playing in the ESCC. Mm-hmm. A lot of good questions we asked him, and he provided some good answers. So that should probably take us all the way up until halftime is over. So we will be back on for the start of the third quarter. Enjoy the interview, and we'll be back with you real soon.
Go Shamrocks!
Team, Nick Coleman's been on the varsity team since he's been a freshman. Adrian Perchnowski and Isaac Moore, Duncan White, been on the team since they've been sophomores. So one of the strengths, I think, of this year's team is the just the experience and the fact that we are a veteran-laden type of team right there.
Okay, Coach, so got a lot of good teams going to play this year, but who do you think is going to be the hardest team to beat?
Yeah, we try to play as tough a schedule as we can to get our team ready for the state tournament. Okay, that's always our ultimate goal right there, go as far as we can in the state tournament. So we want to make sure we're challenged, just not in our conference, but with our non-conference play. But in our conference, I think, St. Vitus has a number of guys coming back. Right? The team over on Dempster Avenue, okay, has a lot of teams, a lot of guys coming back, okay, so they'll be pretty experienced right there. And Bennett is always pretty good. So, but I think in the ESCC conference, top to bottom, okay, there you better be ready to play each and every game out because all the teams are very, very good.
Okay, Coach. Kind of basing it off of what you just said, do you think that the ESCC is the toughest conference in the state?
Yeah, last year was ranked probably in the Chicago Public League, the Red West Conference, and then the ESCC conference, our conference, were probably ranked the two best conferences in the state. So it's It's a reason why I think a lot of our guys come to St. Pat's. Okay, they come obviously from the great academics, a great tradition, the atmosphere in our school. But if you're a basketball player, you certainly want to be challenged week in and week out. And I think it's one of the things that really happens here at St. Pat's within the ESCC conference right there. So it's one of the top conferences year in, year out. Okay, some years maybe a little bit better than others, but when you look throughout the state of Illinois, the ESCC is always one of the top three or four conferences in the state.
Okay, now saying that, your team seems to lack a bit of size, but you do make it up with some good varsity experience. How do you feel about your guys going in the season?
Yeah, We've always been challenged with size. I mean, I shouldn't say always. You know, we've had some teams where we had some guys 6'6", 6'7". We learn how to play with the lack of size. You know, I think it comes down to more teamwork. It comes down to more toughness. It comes down to more just having the right habits, playing together as a team. So I think really high school basketball is more about guards. College basketball and pro basketball is probably a bit more about big men. So give me a team of four point guards and one guy about 6'2", 6'3", they'll bang around a little bit like you two guys maybe. Okay, we could probably use you two guys on the team. But give me a team like that, and that's really how some of our better teams at St. Pat's have played.
All right, Coach. This isn't so much for the year, but just as a personal experience, what do you think your best memory coaching here at St. Pat's?
Yeah, the best memory is always our stud section. To be honest, you know, we've been fortunate enough here. I've been fortunate enough here. Our program has been. We've had some really good players, some outstanding assistant coaches. So we've been successful in the 20-some years I've been here. But I think the best memories we've won some big games. We've won a lot of big games down here on this court right here. But the best memories are just the stud section. All right, when this gym gets rocking and rolling with our guys in the stands, there's not a better atmosphere for high school sports, high school basketball than right here over my left shoulder right here. So just the interaction, you can see the closeness. Our players certainly feel that our student section, our stud section is part of our basketball program. And I think our students, our stud section feels like they are part of our basketball program. So just seeing the energy that they have, just seeing the way that how good they felt after we won the regional championship last year. I think our students felt, and they certainly were a large part of it.
Now, Coach, without getting away in the secrets are here, what are your changes and strategies or schemes this season?
Yeah, you know, really not too many changes. We just kind of go out there and play our man-to-man defense. Just play with some toughness on the defensive end. Try to share the ball as much as we can on the offensive end, and this is a team that really does that. Get our kids to really care about one another, play for one another, okay, instead of playing for themselves, play for one another. And I think if you have those three things, share the basketball, play with toughness on defense, and just have that overall culture that you're going to play for one another. You're playing for the guy to the left, you're playing for the guy to the right, you're playing for the guys in the stud section. If you have those three things covered, I think that you have a chance of being a successful team.
All right, Coach. Obviously, you guys play a lot of different teams, whether it's the SCC, Catholic, CPS. Are there any differences between, say, Catholic League teams and CPS League teams?
Well, yeah, the CPS teams might play a little bit more wide-open basketball, a little bit more scramble basketball, a little bit more fast-break basketball. It seems like that's all from pro basketball to grade school basketball, anywhere in between, it seems like that's kind of the style that a lot of teams are playing. We probably play a little bit more wide open now than what we have in past years. So, you know, basketball's still basketball is the way we always tell our guys. Okay? There's different styles. We'll be challenged right away in our Thanksgiving tournament with three CPS teams in here. They play a little bit more wide open game of basketball, maybe than what we play in the ESCC. But once you get to the state tournament, you're gonna see all different types of styles of basketball. So we try to schedule it that way so that during the season we're exposed to all different styles. So once we get to the state tournament, we're kind of prepared for anything that we might see.
All right, Coach. That's all the time that we have for today. Our Thanksgiving tournament will be coming up next week, I believe, if I'm not mistaken.
Right, start on Monday.
Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday here at Curlin Course. So come on down to see the Shamrocks play. And you can follow us throughout the year. You can follow us on Twitter as well. And we look forward to having all you guys view. So go Shamrocks, and best of luck to you, Coach.
Thanks, guys. Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it.
As you guys saw, there were a lot of fouls, but the Shamrocks came off with a 10-point lead heading into the second half. Coach Bailey has coached a great 2-3 zone to try to protect the paint against our rival IC. So Coach Bailey, he's not only is he a Hall of Fame caliber coach, but I have him in health class. He's just a great guy. He really is. Kind spirit. He's got everything going for him. Now we're going to reflect a little bit on our first half keys. One of the keys to the game was transition defenses set. I would say so far the Shamrocks have capitalized on this. IC hasn't had a great load of fast break points because of our defense. We've really had a bunch of guys back there. Second, good shot selection. For our Shamrocks, we've really had a great shot selection. We've been patient and looking for a good shot to take on offense. Lastly, limit the turnovers. This one, turnovers have been limited, but there have been a lot of fouls that turn the ball over, a couple travels as well. But I'm sure, to reflect, it was a good half for our Shamrocks. I'm sure they'll get things going in the second half. They'll be better with rebounds, and I'm sure they'll be better on the glass. Also, their free throw shooting was very important because IC was in early foul trouble, and the Shamrocks were able to get a lot of points off of free throws from early fouls. So I think the free throw shooting is going to be a big part, and they just really need to get down, dig deep inside, and get some rebounds because they can't allow IC to have that many second chance points. We're approaching about a minute left until our second half starts. For this half, I'm expecting almost a different game. I'm not expecting too many fouls, and I'm expecting more points. I'm sure Nicky Splash, as a leader, he'll get going, and when he's good, all of the Shamrocks are good. Also, I'm afraid to say it, but I think IC's three-point shooters are going to get on. So honestly, I think the game is going to change a lot. Special thanks to our cheerleaders during halftime and our mini cheerleaders. They put together a good routine. Also, shout out to our stud section who has been loud as always here tonight. About 40 seconds left until the second half starts. Little meeting. Coach Bailey's probably telling his guys, we need to get some rebounds and we need to just keep playing our game. If they play their game, they'll come out with a Shamrock W. I am joined now by Paul and Matt, here for a great second half of action. About 10 seconds left until the second half begins. I'm expecting a good half of basketball, a clean half of basketball, and a fun half of basketball.
Hopefully not as foul-ridden as the last one, as I believe there were about 19 fouls at the end of the
first half. Yeah, now, I'd like to give out to our sixth man of today, the student section here at St. Pat's. They've been loud. They've been proud. They've been good today. I wasn't expecting such a big crowd for tonight's game.
It happened when this game started. It was a little lower.
Yeah, pretty dead here.
Yeah, but they've come alive so far, and that's good. It's a big shout out to all of the leaders of the stud section.
They're all jumping around now. They're excited just as we are for a great second half of basketball.
A good rebound there off the missed shot. And Sean Eck brings it up now.
White Thunder with a great first half.
Adrian Berjanowski looking over to Coleman. Coleman to Birch. Birch with the three.
No good.
Transition defense. See how many Shamrocks were there? It was a 4-2 ratio. I like that.
And the three is no good on the other flip side.
Big rebound for our Rocks, but he traveled as he was getting the ball. Ball remains IC.
As I see now going to bring the ball in.
Shamrock's still in that 2-3 zone. I think it's going to be a big key. They can protect the paint, get some good rebounds. Adrian Perjanowski, he's our small forward, but he's playing up in the zone. I think that's to give us a size advantage to better protect the paint. No good,
and
another air ball.
A lot of air balls.
Taken up by...
Trying to get to Andy. Andy gets the shot.
Handai!
Great transition offense there. It's exactly what we want.
Passing around now. Looking. Hirsch guarding heavily. Over, and he's going to miss it. And that'll be our ball.
I think his favorite candy bar might be the Butterfinger after that one.
I think our stud section got in his head. What do
Definitely.
You think, Matt?
I think so. They're loud.
They're playing sloppy right now, I see. Very sloppy. As that's two air balls.
Got to be thinking a timeout from IC is coming. What do you think?
Yeah, it would appear so as of right now. I believe somebody took a timeout.
Shout out to our band who've been faithful all night long.
As they enjoy their third quarter break right now, much deserved. The stud section there.
Another shout out to our referee crew tonight. They've been pretty good. Pretty good.
Definitely.
Yeah, I think they wanted us to notice them after all those fouls called in the first half.
Definitely. With 19, they're trying to tell us.
They want to be known, yeah.
They needed a break for sure after that first half. Very eventful with fouls.
As I would like to give a shout out, as I always do, to the cheerleaders. They really don't get a lot of love.
They do not.
And they really work hard. It's as hard as the basketball team, probably. So much love to them, and thanks for coming out tonight, ladies.
Shout out to our dance team as well, who will be cheerleading in the Orange Bowl.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. It's pretty cool.
Down in Florida.
The dance team couldn't join us tonight for some reasons I have no idea about, but maybe they'll be here next week.
I'm sure they won't miss the Notre Dame game.
What was that? That was an odd play there, and Andy unfortunately can't make the shot.
Yeah, that play you would definitely see on not top 10 on SportsCenter right there.
Definitely. I believe it got blocked. I'm hoping it got blocked.
I hope so.
Very odd sequence of events there.
As it's 31-19 now with 6 minutes left here in the third, our Shamrocks winning. As I see now trying to get something started. Over three, no good.
Bad shot selection from IC, but Shamrocks have benefited. Shonak taking it up. Slows down, looking for something.
Spurgeonowski over to Coleman. Coleman up to Andy Velasquez. Andy threw two men off the rim, but can't get it.
Great offensive board.
Pertz will get it back, though, and Pertz will get
it. Oh, the Polish Prince, baby. Someone call 911, because he's on fire.
Woo!
Wasn't that funny, Paul? Don't flatter me now.
All right.
Flattering well-deserved for that joke.
And I see.
Should really go to stand-up.
And I see it takes the ball. Oh, nice block shot there by Andy Velasquez.
Great steal.
Brings it up now. Passes over. And he won't get the shot. But I'll get it there.
Perch puts it back in.
That'll make it 35-19. The reason I'm laughing, folks, is Mr. Doyle doesn't approve of the Polish Thunder jokes, and I believe we're about to hear about it right now on our screen. As I see now, trying to look for something. I see, bringing it in, trying for the layup, no good. And we'll get the rebound. And the fast break to Bow!
Almost a dunk, but he got fouled. I'm sure if there was no foul, we would have had a first dunk of the 2014 year.
Okay, Perchanowski, I believe you can dunk. Now just go for the easy lay-in, okay? We want layups. We want points. We are up by 16, but wait for the 20 points, Mark, to start going for the slams.
We believe you now.
That would have gotten a loud perch. Definitely a loud perch.
If that went in, that definitely would have been on SportsCenter Top 10.
Definitely would have been. I would have liked to see the Stutzex reaction to that. So go to the line. And he won't get the first, unfortunately.
Very odd by Perch. He's been on his free throws. It's got to be his first or second that he's missed tonight. He's gone to the line for probably about 8 or 9.
Yes. It's been an odd just third period or third quarter in general. A lot of missed shots. A lot of weird plays from Macko Conception. Still get the second there to make it 36-19.
Very odd game, if I do say so.
Yeah, a lot of fouls. Now
just not typical Shamrock basketball.
Yeah, I can't complain. I mean, we're up by almost 20, so.
17-point lead is a good lead, healthy lead, and I'm sure we can build on it soon.
Let's hope so.
Look at this difference. One foul so far. Pretty sure we had 10 in the first quarter.
Yeah, at least. I believe we had 19 total for the half. So it's about halfway through here with only one. That's a good time.
Up.
Three,
and no good.
No good.
Great rebound.
Good defense by Nick Coleman, also known as White Chocolate.
As we stated, as one of our keys to the game is Mr. Doyle doesn't approve of that one either. As we stated before the game, one of the keys tonight was rebounds. And during the game, we were saying how Pats was keeping it close, no good. And we'll get the rebound there, but it will go to IC as Marcus Mercado misses it. One of the keys during the game was that we needed to get rebounds as we weren't really getting a lot.
Coach Bailey said he needed luck, not rebounds, and now he's finally getting those rebounds. I'm sure he's happy about it.
Definitely.
Another rebound for us. Isaac Moore with that one.
Give me
some more of that.
Isaac, give me more, baby.
Nick Coleman over to Mercado. Mercado to back over to Coleman. Well, he passed it to Ismore in between. Going to pass it out to Duncan White. Duncan White's this is the first time I believe he's played since the first quarter. As Coleman takes a deep three. No good.
A little short. IC will get the rebound. We'll try to slow things down, look for something.
Yeah. Because
there's been nothing so far. Shamrock defense is really good tonight.
That was definitely a four shot there. He's going to bring it around now outside the three-point line. Passes it back over to Burroughs.
Foul on...
I believe Duncan White. Yeah, Duncan White, it looks like, for...
Duncan White, I believe that's his second tonight.
His third, I believe it. It says on the board there.
Now I'd like to take the time to thank Mike Acosta, the chess captain here at St. Pat's, for emailing us. In the email, he quoted saying, I like Shimrowski and Misner as a duo. You guys are the next Stacey King and Neil Funk. Well, thank you, Acosta. Maybe you can come join us up in here one day. You know, we like to talk about the chess team a bit, you know, maybe get an interview for that. So thank you, Mike.
Definitely always good to talk about all the smaller clubs.
IC cuts the lead to 15, making both free throws.
As a lot of love goes to, obviously, with the football team and the basketball team. But there's a lot of other clubs going on here, too. So
I believe
good to showcase those, particularly tonight with all the 8th graders here.
Mm-hmm.
I believe the play is also tonight, so
fellow actors break a leg.
Yes, it is. Good luck to them tonight. I hope they're doing well. I believe it's going on right now.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure it's almost over because we're approaching 8 o'clock.
And a foul on somebody here.
Doesn't look like it's on our Shamrocks.
By the way, for any prospective students or parents, I believe you can email Mr. Matt O'Brien at mobrien@sphs.org if you want to schedule for a shadow day or just want to take a tour around the campus. I believe our enrollment test is in late January, if I'm not mistaken, correct?
Yeah, late January sounds right to me, Paul.
Will Lyles, that's his fourth foul tonight. He's in deep foul trouble. They might have to take him out. That'd benefit the Shamrocks, because that's a really tall guy who's not in there.
That'd definitely be. Coleman, Coleman with the wide open look there. He can't drain it, though.
Nicky Splash, no good.
As Nick Coleman not having the best of nights, but luckily Adrian Perchanowski and Dewey taking over for him.
Yeah, a couple kids stepping up tonight.
Sean Eck, one of them as well.
Yes, definitely. One of the keys that the Shamrocks have always been able to do is it seems like they can usually get at least somebody to be having a good night.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The rest of the team's not.
They always pick each other up.
Yeah, exactly.
Paul, I have to ask you, how'd you come up with the name Nicky Splash?
That was not actually me. That was my predecessor, Donnie Rollins, that came up with the nickname Nicky Splash last year. So I owe all the credit to Donnie there.
Fair enough, fair enough. Thank you, Donnie, for that name.
Yes, definitely.
It's perfect for Nick.
It definitely is, Nicky Splash.
What you laughing about there, Matt?
I believe we have some emails if...
Yeah, we got some more emails here.
As you want to take a read a couple of those there, Sham?
We're approaching 2 minutes left in the third.
Well, I got one email here saying, it says, Mr. Doyle's mother says hello. She's enjoying the broadcast. Keep up the good work. Thank you, Mr. Doyle's mother.
Thank you very much.
Proud to see Mr. Doyle's family representing himself tonight.
See we'll put two more points on the board, slim the lead to 13 with about a minute and a half left in this third quarter.
As Isaac Moore, and that'll be...
Another travel on Isaac Moore. I'm not sure what's his issue tonight. My mistake, that was a foul.
Yes, it would appear so. As...
It was Henry Gutschman's second of the night.
Yes, he comes out now.
Henry Gutschman's a junior, if I am not mistaken.
He definitely is. All juniors and seniors this year for the team. I believe we had a sophomore on the team last year.
I'm pretty sure he hasn't got any playing time, but Lawrence Merritt, sophomore, is on the bench.
Yeah, definitely. Ooh, that was a...
little slap by Nicky Splash.
Now we got another email here from Kevin Barzowski, my coworker at Jewel Osco. He would just like to say that me and Paul are doing great. But he's also going to give some credit to Sean Eck, who was playing dauntlessly. That's a vocab word at Mr. Doyle's class. He might get some extra credit for that one.
Hint, hint. As a three there, no good. As they have... Oh, fantastic play there by Isaac Moore to keep it in.
I love that hustle. That's what I love.
Little Dr. J on that one. Gotta respect that land. Beautiful shot by Perch.
Perch!
Can you hear that stud section right now? They're going bananas after that play.
They definitely are. Good to see them out in full force tonight. It always makes a difference when they're here compared to when they're not. Makes the games more fun for the players.
And the fans. When you have all those guys shouting, it's got to be fun to watch.
It keeps it fun for us up here to try and hear what they have to say or see what the people are doing.
Sean Eck on transition. Nikki Splash for three. And
Nikki Splash, baby!
Tingles the twine. Timeout taken by IC, and our crowd is really going nuts now.
They definitely are. 18-point lead now with 36.4 seconds. 41-23, Shamrocks over the IC Knights. Nice play there by Nikki Coleman. I'm hoping I think that's his first.
I believe so.
First three of the night. Big, big for the Shamrocks.
Definitely. As a timeout here, as we pan to a couple of people in the crowd. Just looking around, good to see all the people.
Pretty big crowd for a game that's not in conference.
Definitely, as I believe our first conference game is against Notre Dame, so that's always a big one.
You see Aaron Rodriguez there, he's not dressed for the game. He is actually out with a sprained ankle. I'm not sure how long he'll be sidelined, and that's why you haven't seen him tonight.
That's always tough. He didn't play a whole lot last year, but the key to his season was, at least when we watched, he made every single three-point shot he took, which admittedly was only about 10, but every single shot that he took, he made.
Think about it, that's 30 points.
Yeah.
And there you see Lawrence Merritt, the sophomore.
The future of the Shamrocks.
Very good player. I think he netted at least 20 points in the sophomore's victory.
They won big two, I believe, by about 25 over the IC sophomore team.
The freshman A team and the sophomore A team both came away with big victories. Freshman team probably about 30, I think.
That's good.
And it looks like the varsity team is running away with this one, so it might be an undefeated night for our Shamrocks. It's always good to hear.
Yeah, Coach Bailey's really been doing good these last couple years with these recruiting classes, getting some nice talent from these young men.
There's almost a shadow every day here, potential talent for our basketball program.
Definitely is. Mr. O'Brien's done a fantastic job since coming in here as recruitment director.
Coach O'Connor as well.
Definitely. Everybody puts a good...
Here comes Nikki Splash.
And he'll get fouled. With 4.9 seconds left here, 41-23.
Did that bucket by Perch count, or was Nikki Splash fouled on the play?
I think they got Nikki Splash on the line here.
Yeah, it would appear so for two here, as this will probably be the last play of the third quarter. I see they'll probably try and bring the ball up and just try for a half-court shot, but as trying to go up by 20 here with the two free throws, let's hope he can make it.
Now what I love about Nick Coleman is that his free throw form is as sweet as sugar. With those bent knees and that elbow pointing straight to the rim, you got to admire that shot.
Very smooth. Very smooth.
Definitely.
More smooth than a baby's bottom.
Okay, Sham. Okay.
Sham wow.
Haven't heard that one before.
We're waiting for Mr. Doyle's reaction to that one. He doesn't look too happy. He's coming in with...
The lead is 19 for the Shamrocks.
As I believe IC is taking a timeout. As the air ball almost made it in.
Shamrocks with a three-quarter shot just barely misses. That would have been fun to watch, and our stud section would have been going crazy.
Definitely. At the end of the third quarter, we are now. It's 42-23. Shamrocks over IC right now. A very dominant third quarter there.
Hey, Paul, who's out there on the court right now?
I believe it is the cheerleaders. Always good to see.
Always good to see.
Now, I'd like to give a shout-out to Mr. Doyle and his family, Keaton and Kenneth, and his wife are watching from home. So, hello, guys. How you doing?
It's always good to hear and see from them. They're usually one of them is at the game.
Yeah. Sorry if I mispronounce your names. I believe we got some John Jacob going on in the stud section.
Always good to see. One of the greatest moments, I'd have to say, was... I was talking to a kid who went to, I believe, Maine South, and we were discussing basketball, and he asked me what school I went to. And, of course, I told him where I went. And he said that being here and looking at the stud section was one of the most frightening things he had ever seen in his life. He said that we are by far the most nuts school he has ever seen. And when he said that, I beamed with pride.
Yeah, yeah. And you think we're scary. Look at the coaches out there holding us back. Coach Madsen, Coach Galante, Coach Mordan down there in the front of the battle lines. It's scary down there with those big men.
We got to give them props. Because that's a tough job to try and restrain a bunch of hyped up teenagers. But they do a good job of it.
Big boys with some big courage up there.
Definitely, definitely.
Shaunak looking for something.
As we start this third.
Over to Duncan White. Not much playing time tonight, but he's capitalized with some good defense and some good boards.
Hopefully the Shamrocks can... They don't have to do a whole lot in this third period. They just have to continue to play good defense and we can take home a win here pretty easy. Hopefully we can see some more good three-point shooting. It's Duncan White here with the three.
No good.
Not the best shot. Oh, and they're going to miss the rebound there.
Perch almost with another offensive board. It's been big tonight.
He definitely has been. Perch is probably MVP of the game so far.
I would definitely say so
with
myself.
Three-point shot. No good. Nice rebound there by, I believe, Nick Coleman.
I think that's a big reason why they're down.
To Perch, and he'll get it.
There you go, Perch.
Perch.
Big reason why I see is down is their three-point shooting has been not nearly as good.
They've only made, I believe, one three-pointer. Oh, excuse me. They've only made
one
three-pointer the entire game. I had to wait for a minute there just to be sure.
You don't want to jinx anything.
Their big man scored 45. Right now, neither team has even scored that much. Oh,
Nicky Splash doing it dirty, but he's getting it done.
Yeah, definitely.
He weaves through that defense so effortlessly. It's just so fun to watch Nicky play.
He does. He doesn't even have to score as much as he could just dictate. Because if he could dictate the team well enough, then the team will do fine.
Yeah, he's one of those guys that when he's on the court, he makes everybody else better, regardless of how he's playing.
Definitely. I believe a foul on the Shamrocks here. Yeah, and Duncan White is fourth. That's probably why he hasn't played a whole lot.
Lead is 23 now for our Shamrocks. Really, really started slow, but they really picked it up.
Definitely.
No good for at the line. Duncan White checks out, and in comes Isaac Moore. He's been a beast on the boards tonight.
He definitely has been. Only 8 fouls in this half so far, which is good because of the 19 that we had in the first half.
We had more in the first quarter than we've had so far in this whole half.
Yeah,
it's
definitely
ridiculous.
Isaac Moore is a kid who's been playing varsity basketball since, I believe, his sophomore year. So he's got some experience here.
Put back. No
good. Oh, and
Isaac takes it in.
Back, and he gets it on the third time or fourth time's a charm there.
That one was as easy as taking candy from a baby for Isaac.
Now, why would you do that? That's just mean.
No reason to do that.
Sorry, Sham.
As they will get the
lead could be
shot in the paint.
Lead could be 25 if the Shamrocks capitalize. Isaac to Nick. To Perch.
Perch looking for something. Just going to keep it slow. That's all we need to do here with 5:55 left. 48-25, our Shamrocks. Over to
Nicky
Coleman.
Nicky Splash in the corner. Ooh, and it's good. Was that a 2 or 3?
That was a 2-pointer.
Lead the 25 now.
It's looking good for our Shamrocks. As Trey Burrows now looking for something.
They've doubled our guests' points tonight.
And a
foul by Isaac Moore. That is his...
I believe it's second or third.
I want to it's his first.
Oh, it's his first. He's played a good game.
Stayed clean so far.
That's some Isaac, do not give me more stuff right there.
Yeah, we could do without those fouls there. No, we're up by 25. I mean, we don't have to foul here. Just, you know.
Play the game safe and come out with a W.
Got to be conservative in this moment.
And he'll get it.
What do you think of his free throw routine? Wasn't very wasn't normal.
I'll have to take a look here. I wasn't paying as close attention. Let's see what he does here. It's kind of an odd release.
Yeah, it looks like he kind of just pushes
comes
the
up
ball.
Fast.
Yeah. He looks like I shoot a ball, which is, I'm not good at basketball, so.
Yeah.
He probably should change that.
24 points to lead now.
Good to see here for the Shamrocks. As this was one of those games that I was looking at and I was talking to the guys, and they were confident in themselves, but they admitted that they were a little bit nervous, so I'm glad to see that they were able to come out here. They've been playing great so far. Hopefully we can keep it up.
Now what I want to see is I want to see them try to get this lead up to 30 to get a real revenge game on these guys for beating us by 30 last year. Should be good for this team and a real confidence boost.
I was just about to say that. You almost read my mind, Shane.
As we'll get another two-pointer there.
And she's trying to bring it up fast, maybe get some quick buckets.
And
get some momentum.
God, is airballed again.
Ooh, my. And Gorski goes down.
You better watch out there.
I think Isaac Moore gave him a knee to the face.
Well, I'll have to talk to him about that one after the broadcast is over.
Someone get Trainer Joe to look at Pat. He might be a little hurt here.
Of course, unintentional.
He may be concussed. We don't know.
Great screen by Isaac. Cleared it up for
Sean Eck to take it. Hurt. No good. And I believe... I believe it's Shamrock ball, actually. Yes, it is Shamrock ball.
That's what you like to see.
Well, you got
to
love. You got to love. Shamrocks are up 52-26 here. Coach Bailey is still running up and down the sideline, talking to his guys, getting them to play the basketball he wants them to play.
If it was up to Coach Bailey, I'm sure he'd win every game by 100 if he could.
Definitely. As Perch.
Out of bounds. IC ball.
With 4:17 left here, 52-26. Very dominant performance so far by the Shamrocks. As they're going to inbound the ball here. Looking around, trying to take the three. Not going to make it again. And they'll get the rebound, though. And they won't make that either, but they'll get the rebound again. And they'll finally make it. Third time's a charm.
Put that in. That took way too long.
Definitely. It's a time waster. That's their problem is they're... Oh, nice.
Steal there.
Yeah, that was a good steal.
I see he's looking for some spark.
And not going to get it. Nice rebound there by Isaac Moore.
Although they're getting almost blown out, I see. I'm glad to see they're fighting. It's still a game.
And they will make their second three-pointer of the night.
Now it's 21-point lead. Got trimmed. I'm glad to see a respectable for the Shamrocks.
Yes, definitely here as we close in with 3 minutes and 30 seconds to go. Hopefully the Shamrocks don't really need to do a whole lot.
In checks, Duncan White.
As I believe... they're going to take a timeout. I don't know which side took it. And probably figure perhaps the Shamrocks. As the Blackhawks play tonight, I believe, against the Montreal Canadiens. I'm not quite sure what the score is. I believe the game should probably be about towards the end of the first period now. They've been playing a lot better. They started off kind of slow at about a 500 team, but I believe they've won five straight. That's always a positive thing to see. So they're actually they're getting up there to be ranked one of the top in the NHL. So Patrick Kane, Brad Richards, and Christopher Stieg line, I believe I actually just read today in 8 games has produced 37 points together. So, I mean, when you got guys scoring in such high numbers, you really can't complain.
Yeah, man.
They've really been good. Hopefully our Shamrocks can almost mirror that performance.
Hopefully.
Play as good as our Blackhawks do. And as you can see in the crowd, a couple of fans have some Blackhawk hats on, and I can't blame them. One of Chicago's bright spots, along with our Shamrocks.
Definitely. I wore a Chicago Blackhawks hat here today. It's currently lying somewhere in the studio. Hopefully I know where it is.
It's probably on the floor with your Starburst wrappers.
Yes. For one of our practice broadcasts, I enjoy eating Starbursts, and Mr. Doyle was upset with me that I made a mess. It's cleaned up now, folks.
We'd like to apologize for the scoreboard. It appears to be off your screen. I wish I remembered the score. I believe it was 52-26, so it's not a close game, so we don't have to really worry about that. But we'll keep you posted.
Definitely. Sorry about that, folks. It's our first
Sean
game
Sean taking it down, looking for something, trying to stall, I'd imagine.
Yeah, I think they're just gonna try and pass the ball around here.
I think it's close to about 2 minutes left.
Yeah, probably somewhere around there. It's Duncan White.
It would have been a good shot to take, but they're trying to stall.
That's fair. They're up by 25. Andy Velasquez there. Nearly lost it.
The only shot Coach Bailey's going to accept here is something inside the paint.
Definitely.
Something inside the paint and wide open.
As our stud section there, looking quite good. Looking quite good today.
Probably excited for a big win in about a minute and a half, I guess.
Sorry again about this, folks. I believe it is still 52-26, if we're not mistaken. 52-31, I believe. 52-31, my apologies. Hopefully, they're going to take the three here. It'll and another air ball.
Not shocked they missed that one. It's been a story of the night tonight.
That's probably about their 10th air ball.
Yeah, a lot of air balls today.
They're about two for probably about 20 behind the line, and they're usually 20 out of 20.
They look like me back in my alley, playing the ghost defender.
Definitely. Of course, it's hard when you're playing an actual basketball game. Yeah, you can't miss that. As Bobby Jarkowski there.
Bobby trying to get some cabbage
class
time.
Class of 2015. Oh, nice play there.
Good.
I believe it's about 55-31 now.
Another 2 points for Sean Eck. He's been a great bright spot. I'd have to say between him and Perch for the MVP. We'll let Sham decide that at the end of this one.
Definitely.
It's been a great day of basketball today, and I think a lot of these Shamrock students are going to go to the old malt shop and celebrate with a nice chocolate malt. So have fun tonight, Shamrocks. Be safe.
Definitely going to be living like it's 1955. Smooth roller. Thank you.
Score is 54-31 as of now.
And a shout out to our director, Bobby Jarkowski, coming in here last minute on the fly, being able to take over. As they're just going to try and pass the ball around right now. As I believe we have an email.
And I got an email here from Alex DeJesus. I feel that the team is doing a tremendous job playing dauntlessly. After the televised debacle last year, that's a vocab word, Mr. Dora. I'm sorry, I mispronounced it. They turned it around and played hard. Nick and Adrian are doing a great job stepping up and taking over. Also, Andy is doing a great job cleaning up the boards. I have to agree with you, Alex. Thanks for the email. Thanks for the love. See you at school Monday.
We all appreciate the emails that you guys write. It's always fun to hear what people have to say.
Really is. I like to hear our feedback so that we know how we're doing and obviously how our Shamrocks are doing.
Definitely. As we're going to figure about a minute left here. 54-31, I believe the score was from our man Bobby Tarkowski.
Regardless of what we know, I'm sure the stud section will give us a countdown when there's about 10 seconds left.
Definitely, I'm sure. As a great night for the Shamrocks.
As it looks like everybody's putting in the second team here. And a lot of new faces out there in the court.
We've got Henry Goochman. He's 41 there. Marcus is back checked in with his mask on. We have the sophomore, Lawrence Meriden, I believe.
Along with, I lost his name, I'm sorry.
Dewey's back in there as well.
As they're just going to try and play keep away right now. Or they're going to take the shot.
Not a good shot. Luckily, we got a rebound, but Dewey fell hard.
Yeah, he did. He looked hurt there for a second. He looks okay now, though.
It's not what you want to see in this kind of game.
Definitely.
I think Isaac checked back in, as well as...
I believe sophomore Michael Killian is out there, if I'm not mistaken.
We have the start the buses chance going right now.
Better start my mom's minivan, because I want to get out of here.
Beat the crowd.
Oh, and a nice steal there. He'll go for it. And he got fouled. Then I believe he got the point.
It's Michael Killian, the sophomore right there. Great play by that kid.
And one.
As the crowd chants, he's a sophomore. He is a sophomore. Good job, boys. He is not a junior, a freshman, or
thankfully, they know they're a student body.
That's always good.
Good sign from our stud section. Ooh. And he hits it. That's a three-point play. Very good to see from a sophomore here.
Definitely.
They're mopping up.
Get used to that name, folks. Michael Killian. Next 3 years, Shamrock basketball.
Fun stuff. As I see now, going to miss that shot, but look at the rebound. They're going to drive it back in, and he'll get that one.
Yeah, looking like Derrick Rose out there.
Yeah, got a nice little fader there.
Nice floater. Got it to go.
Floating like a butterfly, stinging like a bee.
Luckily, not so much stinging like a bee tonight.
I don't know what we'd do without you, Sham.
We certainly wouldn't have the comedic element. Ooh. Oh, and he stole the ball and left the ball.
I don't think that kid knows how to dribble. Give him a break.
Pro tip, you need to keep the ball with you. And a three-point shot there. They will finally, number three. Lucky number three. Mr. Doyle, not pleased with that last remark. Sorry, Mr. Doyle.
I'm sorry.
As I believe we're probably getting into the final 30 seconds, I figure. As they're really just holding the ball.
I believe like 5 seconds left. And
there
the
it is. It's a win for our Shamrocks tonight.
Looks like the student section is storming the court.
A big W for our Shamrocks.
Always good to see. So, who would you guys say were the MVPs of the game?
I'll leave this one up to Sham, but if I was to say mine, it'd be Perch.
I would have to say Perchanowski played a great game. Nick Coleman, leader of the team, you always got to put him in that discussion here.
Yeah,
but
he's worthy.
I want to talk about the defensive play by all the players here. They played great. Thank you to the referees for giving IC a couple fouls that I enjoyed. Great game overall by all the Shamrocks.
Sham, I don't know if this is possible, but can we give the MVP to that 2-3 zone? Because they played great tonight.
I say we should give the MVP to Coach Bailey, the Silver Fox, for his great coaching.
Definitely. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us tonight here at Curlin Court. The final score is, I believe, since our cameras unfortunately went out, 57 points for the Shamrocks, and I believe about 34 for Immaculate Conception. We want to give a thanks to Coach Bailey for his pre-recorded halftime interview that was done by yours truly, me, and Matt Chomrowski, and recorded by Pat Gorski, class of 2015. We want to express our gratitude to some of the behind-the-scenes people who have made it possible for this production to be made. Pat Gorski, camera operator slash technical director, and Bobby Jarkowski, who was, I believe, our technical director for tonight. Michael Pasquale, camera director. Marty McGovern, camera director as well. Without those guys, tonight would not have been possible. And, of course, we want to give our thanks to our commander-in-chief, the great Mr. Doyle. So, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Paul Meisner, class of 2015.
I'm Matt Chomrowski, class of 2015.
And I'm Anthony Pasquale, class of 2018.
Join us again here on Friday, December 19th, 2014, when we take on our hated foes, Notre Dame, here at Curlin Court, as Anthony takes the reins. We wish him the best of luck. We'll be here at Ustream TV at 7 o'clock.
I'd just like to say one thing. Doyle rules!
I'd like to add one thing as well. Drive home safely as the Shamrocks pull out a big win.
Have a nice night, folks. We'll see you later.